arrive early today, Florence. Maybe we might get lucky. We did do pretty good yesterday, didn't we? Okay, Florence. This looks like a pretty good place.
Pilgrim, where are you going to in such a hurry?
I can't talk now, Coop. Barney's chasing me. See you later.
Oh, hello there, Barney. How are you? I've seen you around in the lawn.
I don't want you to. That new rent owes me $5 and I'm going to collect. You're in big trouble. That corner's my territory, and you're gonna pay me to use it. I'm gonna find out where you hide, and I'm gonna come, and I'm gonna pound it out of you.
Nice trunk. Wonder why anybody would throw it in the garbage.
I'll heat up some lasagna. It's fantastic.
I'll come back later if that's all right with you. I want to get this trunk back to my place.
Sure, come on back for supper.
Thanks, Wilma.
I wonder what he's up to now.
Thank you.
Stands for. Now that's very strange, Florence. Let's see what's in here, okay, Florence? I'm gonna hang it up over there, okay? There's even more pictures. Look at this old hat. I wonder if it fits. No, I guess not. You know, this hat looks like the same one that guy has in the picture. Here's his coat. Look at the old book. A home remedy book. How to cure a cold in your head. Cut the rind off an orange very thin. Roll it up inside out and thrust one roll in each nostril.
Yuck! Who would ever do that?
You know, Florence, I think there's a false bottom in this trunk. Maybe, just maybe, there's jewels or something in there. It is a false bottom! Scary in there. That's funny. There's no hole in the floor. Find out what that is.
You have a bad taste in your mouth, especially in the mornings.
Well, if so, my friend, Zachariah Gibson has the answer to your prayers. A potion so powerful that it may easily rid you of all these ailments and many, many more. Ladies and gentlemen,
this is 1870.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is 1875, and we need a modern medicine for our times.
Florence,
Did he say it was 1875? Wow. We've gone way back in time. It's 100 years ago. Boy, old Coop wasn't even born then.
Good people, the mild, soothing properties of this elixir can conquer the worst cases imaginable.
Shh! Horace, be quiet!
Good people, the mild, soothing properties of this elixir can conquer...
Lawrence, be quiet. We're in big trouble. Oh, no, Florence. Look what you've done now.
Well, well, well. Isn't this a fine how-do-you-do? I hope you can explain just what you're doing in my trunk. With a frog, young man.
Well, sir,
are you here to spy on me?
I was just...
To watch me rehearse my act? To steal the secret formula from my magic elixir?
Your what?
Come, come, now don't play the innocent with me. Out of there and on your way home.
But I can't. I don't live around here.
Then just where do you live?
Back down here.
Young man, are you trying to tell me that you live in my trunk?
Well, no, I don't know how I got here.
Young man, I am very quickly beginning to lose my patience with you.
Barney was chasing me. I hid in the trunk that was in the garbage. I took it to my secret hideout, and it didn't have any bottom in it. So I climbed in and came out here. Only it's 100 years ago.
What do you mean, 100 years ago?
Where I come from, it's in the 1970s. You just said it was 1875.
1970s? You know, that is very likely the daftest story I ever heard. Come on, out of there. We'll find out where you live.
You there? I say you there! Mr. Gibson! Mr. Zachariah Gibson!
Madam, welcome to my humble wagon. Could I interest you in a little elixir to ease your pains or lift your spirits?
Mr. Gibson, you are a fraud and a cheat. This elixir is worthless.
Sing along and have fun with today's special, coming up next on the Access Network.